Amigos, ¿cómo están? Una edición más de Auto 060. Tenemos un show muy interesante con test drives de un auto que es casi perfecto. Ya van a escuchar enseguida de qué se trata. También vamos a hablar del Project Yellow Light, una iniciativa en la que está involucrada Mazda para alertar a los jóvenes principalmente a evitar esa mala costumbre de manejar y enviar mensajes de texto. Vamos a hablar de la nueva Chevy Silverado, la nueva pickup truck de la General Motors que está saliendo en su nueva generación para competir con la Ford F-150, que es, como ustedes saben, el vehículo más vendido acá en Estados Unidos durante más de 3 décadas, casi 40 años de hecho ya. Y también vamos a hablar con otra iniciativa sobre educación de Ford para interesar a los chicos en temas de ingeniería, de ciencias y todo este tipo de cosas. Así que I'm going to switch now to English because we have a very special guest. We have Jake Fisher from Consumer Reports. How are you, Jake?
I'm doing good.
Excellent. Well, so we were talking in the introduction about a test drive that Consumer Reports did recently, and something really rare happened there because you rarely give almost a perfect score to any cars, but it happened with the Tesla Model S, right?
Yeah, well, we're finished testing with the Tesla Model S here at our track, and this car performed better than any car we've tested before. It really was a very impressive automobile.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing the amount of good news that this car has gotten since it came out, and it's just getting better. I mean, like a report from you, which is a very influential opinion. I mean, the last time you did this was in 2007 with the Lexus LS460L. So what made exactly this car achieve this almost perfect score?
Well, the car really does just about everything very well. So imagine, if you will, a very fast sports car that handles great, accelerates very fast, has great braking. Now imagine that vehicle also has plenty of utility. You could be set up to 7 people, very comfortable, rides well, and it's the quietest vehicle you've ever driven. That's what this car is. That's what the Tesla is.
That's incredible, because as you said, in your report, you said it's almost like you drive like a sports car, like a Porsche. It has the luxury of an Audi and better than some hybrids in terms of efficiency. And it's very interesting to talk more about that, because most people still have a lot of doubts about electric cars, with the charging, with the infrastructure, with the pricing, with the range anxiety. So this car, in your opinion, has pretty good points in all of those issues, right?
Yeah, I mean, the way the car performs just is mind-blowing. It's just brilliant. Now, in terms of electric cars, you're absolutely right. Range anxiety is real, and with the other vehicles that we've tested that are electric, the electric range is only maybe 70 miles, 80 miles that you could really do, which really limits what you could do. And sometimes when you're driving somewhere and, you know, you decide you want to stop at the grocery store on the way back, or have to pick up your kids, you're sweating, making sure that you're going to make it back.
Or if there's traffic.
Or if there's traffic, or if it's raining, or if you turn the lights on, or if you need to turn the heat up.
Yeah.
These all affect your range. Now, this vehicle, and really this is not one of the huge innovative things about the battery, is just it's a bigger battery.
Okay.
Pretty simple solution. It's a much larger battery than we've seen in any of the other electric cars. So you're going to get a real life range of around 200 miles.
Yeah.
So no, you can't go and drive this car across the country. But for most people, if you think about your driving,
yeah, you're getting a tire before the battery runs out, right?
most people aren't driving more than 200 miles every day.
Yeah. And even for long trips, let's say we're based here in Miami. Let's say we're going to Orlando, which is more or less that distance. You pretty much are gonna end there your driving day anyway, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, here's the thing. It's like the car is not made for long trips. You know, if you're going to take a long trip once in a while, you're probably gonna have another vehicle, or who knows, you could even rent a car.
Yeah.
But if you're daily driving is less than 200 miles every night, you charge it up when the car's in your garage, and the next morning you're all set, and you never have to go to a gas station.
Yeah, and that's the other interesting point in your report, because you said that the cost of charging the car, it was about $9, which is equivalent to paying $1.20 for a gallon of gas. So that's another huge advantage.
Basically, fuel gets very cheap when you're driving a Tesla. It gets the equivalent of about 84 miles per gallon if you look at it in terms of the cost and the energy use.
Yeah.
So this car, I mean, not only is it far more energy efficient than any hybrid vehicle, but, you know, you compare it to a Prius, which is the poster child of efficiency, and you're delivering, you know, basically twice as many miles for your the energy you're putting in.
Yeah. And the other thing is, I mean, the car is expensive. I mean, it's like the one that you tested is about, what, $90,000, right?
We spent $90,000 on our car, yes.
Yeah, which is another interesting, as you said, we spent, because there's another point. We're talking to Jake Fisher, who is the head of automotive testing at Consumer Reports, which is an independent magazine, as you know, well, more than a magazine, an organization. Can you please explain the process of your test drives, please?
Sure. Well, we do a full road test and when here at a track. So we're in central Connecticut. We have a 327-acre test facility, which we put 75 vehicles through every year. And this vehicle we purchased. It was not loaned to us from Tesla. We got a real vehicle, just like you would get. And we put it through over 50 tests, everything from ergonomics to track performance, to what it's like to live with. And we've put thousands of miles on this car.
Yeah.
And we've lived with it, and I put my kids in the, it actually has, it's a five-seater, but it has two more seats in the rear that are rear-facing.
Yeah, like the one that fold inside, right?
Yeah, they fold out of the floor, and, you know, I had my kids in there, and they love sitting back there and waving at the trucks behind them.
Yeah.
And we live with these vehicles.
Yeah. So for how long did you test it?
We've had it for several months now, you know, as we put thousands of miles on the vehicle.
Yeah, and the other thing that you mentioned in the report is that even though, I mean, this is not a perfect car. I mean, there are some issues that we already have mentioned some of them. But you said, for example, the battery tests are still going on and some things like that?
Okay, so this is not a perfect car. And like we already talked about in terms of, you can't drive it across the country. I could do that with a Corolla.
Yeah,
can't do that with this car. But the other issue is reliability. So before we recommend a vehicle at Consumer Reports, we want to make sure that this car has good reliability so you're not going to wind up having problems.
Yeah.
There's not enough data on these vehicles yet to know that. And the vehicle that we've owned, we've had some issues with this car, and we know there has been issues with other Teslas. This is a brand new vehicle from basically a very new company,
mm-hmm.
too. So it wouldn't be that surprising to see some growing pains in this vehicle.
No, absolutely. I mean, a car, most people don't even think much about the process of making it and producing it and maintaining it. But like when you press a button, you expect everything to function perfectly. But every single car, I mean, look at Toyota, right? I mean, they're like the most reliable cars, and they have had the most recalls in recent years. So, but still, it's pretty amazing technology. What did you think about the huge display in the front console of it? It's like two iPads together, right?
Yeah, it's basically a 17-inch iPad, and anyone who's used to Apple products will be right at home.
Yeah.
Works very, very simply, very well. It gives you a lot of options, maybe too much options. You can actually surf the internet while you drive with a full browser.
Which might not be very
I would not recommend that.
Yeah, exactly.
I would not recommend that. But it's a beautiful display, and it gives you a lot of, you know, the vehicles come with a data plan, so they're hooked up. You can stream your radio off the internet. You can search Google for destinations and Google Maps. It really is a very high-tech experience.
Yeah, and the design of it is pretty much, I mean, one of the things I think you said is like the visibility in the back is not as good, but the outside design is pretty good, I think. I mean, I like the car. I mean, it looks pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, the car does a really good job of being kind of, you know, gorgeous, but also very functional inside and very large inside. And we've seen other vehicles that look great. I mean, the Fisker Karma looks gorgeous, but it's got no room inside.
Yeah.
The Porsche Panamera is well, I don't think that's a very nice looking car.
Yeah, me neither. Yeah, from the outside, it's kind of, it's like an acquired taste, if you want to name it. But once you get inside, it's beautiful.
Yeah, but it's like, you know, we see a lot of, you know, cars sacrificing the room inside for swoopy styling. This does a great job of being very functional and roomy inside and still looking great. And you know, just to talk again about, you know, the fact you could fit seven people if two of them are kids. Yeah. And it's got a huge front trunk as well as the rear cargo area.
So, Jake Fisher, director of automotive testing for Consumer Reports, do you think we're seeing, we're like in the presence of like the car of the future that like most cars are going to look in or function in 15, 20 years or something like that?
Yeah, I think in many ways. I mean, first of all, this takes the electric car and really changes the opinion of what you might think of an electric car. No longer is it the electrified golf cart.
Yeah.
This is like a very desirable vehicle that's very engaging and fun to drive. But more than that, there's a lot of things about this vehicle that just is changing. It's not even just about being an electric car. The way you function with this vehicle, about the 17-inch iPad that drives the vehicle, this car doesn't have a start switch.
Yeah.
When you get in the vehicle, it's ready to go because it knows you got in the car and it kind of assumes you want to drive.
Wow.
When you leave the car, you don't have to lock it. If you walk out with the key, it locks for you. There's a lot of innovative things about this car, which I would not be surprised to see in other vehicles, whether or not they're hybrid or gasoline or diesel going forward.
Well, fascinating. Thank you very much for your time, Jake Fisher. As I said, Director of Automotive Testing for Consumer Reports. So, and the webpage is at consumerreports.org, right? For
correct.
To look for more of the test drives and all the information about cars and many other things. Well, thank you very much, Jake, and nice talking to you, and maybe one day we'll go over there and test drive a car with you.
All right, sounds good. You're very welcome.
Thank you very much. Jake Fisher, director de pruebas automotrices de Consumer Reports, probando el Tesla Model S, el vehículo que sacó una puntuación de 99 puntos de 100 posibles. La primera vez que sucede esto en 6 años, la última vez que sucedió fue con un Lexus. Y como decía Jake Fisher ahí, este auto no solamente es por la cuestión de que es un auto eléctrico, sino que tiene una cantidad de innovación tecnológica impresionante. Hemos colocado un link a la review en inglés y en español en nuestra página de Facebook para que lo revisen y compartan las opiniones. Un auto fascinante realmente. Y cuando regresemos vamos a hablar de la, como decía en la introducción del show, del Project Yellow Light, en el que Mazda está involucrado para alertar a los chicos sobre los peligros de manejar y enviar mensajes de texto al mismo tiempo. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota. Ya regresamos.